Would you do arch push-ups for time?
Please say no, please say no.
No, I wouldn't do that for time, but you wanna get strong? Do them, have some fun. This one's gonna be a ring fly. Unlike your traditional ring, or your fly that you see guys in the gym, and what was the cue we were taught as kids, as guys, to do flies? Like you're hugging a barrel? Yeah, you guys remember that cue? It's a little bit different gymnastics. We're gonna set up our back, turn our wrists out straight, and it's gonna be full straight arm development. So he's gonna lean out, arms are straight, I'm supporting him, pause, pull back in with straight arms. His hand didn't move, but watch that. Go out again, down, 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 down. He didn't slide his hand, but look where he is. Is that a false grip? Yeah, because the hand's on top. He's just letting the wrist bend. So it shortens that leverage a little bit. He doesn't need to adjust or slide the hand. He's actually squeezing that ring tighter and letting the wrist flex a little bit. Cool? One more time. Down, pause, come out. All right, take one step backwards. He looks good, let's load him up a little more. I'm spotting him, down, pause, arms are straight, come up. This time he's gonna mess with me. One of his arms is gonna bend, I'm gonna find out which one and fix it. I'll show you guys how to fix it. Let's go down, pause. I'm gonna pull him in, flick him, good. Now, let's get out of there. Let's redo that position. Arms straight, push away, down, 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 pause, pull out, take a break. Same thing, slowly but surely getting down to here. Your hand does not wanna go past your chest. We're not extending that shoulder. Second thing is, you wanna initiate your chest, your shoulders, and your lats as you pull. If you're pulling in and arching your back, you're disengaging half your muscle groups. You're disengaging your back. Your back is pulling here. So if you think, tucking your chest in, squeeze your hollow, and as you pull, pull from the chest, push the rings away, tuck your arms in, hold as you come back down, keep that tension on. Do not relax those shoulder blades, otherwise they'll be out of position and you will fall straight down. I'm just trying to tell you. So think about pulling through the shoulder, pushing away, pulling in, but keep that back nice and hollow. If you don't, you disengage your platform completely. Make sense? Take it easy on this one. I want your elbows to be safe, but let's see what you guys can do. Get loaded up a little bit. If they look good, only then you can load them up. If they don't look good, keep them at a scale. Bam! So squeeze the crap out of that ring. Now get underneath them, just in case, he might fall. Good, stop right there. Pull out a little bit, arm straighter, arm straighter. Okay, now let's finish the rep. Let's do that again. Let's only go halfway.
Might have to scale this one, I think.
Yeah, okay, no, let's only do a half rep right now. Okay. So you get underneath and spot him, Ryan. Get close, adjust your head as need be. Arms are straight. I will tell you when to stop. So let's go down, 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 pause. One, two, get out of there. Good, the arm stayed straight, so let's repeat that. Turn out, go. Down, down, pause, one, two, get out. That's better. So that's gonna be your scale. We're gonna deload you and do just half reps until you keep that arm straighter. Because you're probably used to doing so many flies, if your arm's bent, you have that muscle memory involved. Okay? So just a few more, let's change the technique. So wrist out, arm straight. Yeah, and now you can see his arms, right? Pause, one, two, get out of there. Good, better.